Hi children, in our previous class, force. In that, you have seen push and pull on an object is called, and also we have given another definition for force as a force is an agent which can change the shape, size, state of rest, state of motion of an object. So here let us see the first introductory part of your chapter in the given in the textbook. Here you can see some pictures. The introduction of part of the textbook is given by using some pictures. Here you can see the picture, a boy standing in front of headmaster's room, and he is going to enter into the room and he reads the words given on the door. Push. From outside he can see push. He can read it as push. And he pushed the door and entered into the room. While coming out of the room, he again reads the word written on the door. He can read it as pull. So he will be pulling the door and to comes out of the room. And here another two pictures you can see. And the first picture is a man pulling the cart. And the second picture is a person is pushing the cart. So two pictures are given, push and showing push and pull. Examples for push and pull that you have to fill in these boxes. First one, pushing a car. Second, pushing the door. Pulls the cart. Pulls the door. So these examples you can fill in your textbook. Now the second page, also there are number of pictures given. What is the first picture shows? A ball which rolls on the floor and the person applying a force in the opposite direction, from the opposite direction of motion of the ball. And here a goalkeeper try to save the goal. And then another person is trying to beat the ball with a bat. And here this picture, next picture, D represent a pressing the sponge. And picture E represent a man pulls the cow. And here last picture represent a person push the wall. And here in the chart, after this picture, asking to analyzing the picture, the result of applying the force of on different objects. So first one is done for you. Applying a force on a rolling ball, slowly pushing it in the opposite direction with the leg. And what is the result of that action? The ball comes to rest. So if a person try to if a person applying a force opposite direction of motion, the ball comes to rest. And in the next picture, pushing a wall. Here last picture here. A wall, you can see, isn't it? So what is the result of action activity? The wall has a tendency to move. So that may be the result of the activity. The wall has a tendency to move. Now you can select one more picture from the. Take the man pressing the sponge. So by pressing the sponge, what he is doing? Pushing the. Okay, you can write push the sponge. Okay. What's that activity? The shape of the sponge changes. A change in the shape of the sponge. Okay. So that you have to write here. What is it? Sponge changes its shape. So here is given what we discussed in the previous class. Force is that which changes or tends to change the shape, size, volume, state of rest or state of motion of a body. So I explained it already. Force is an agent which changes or tends to change the shape, size, volume, state of rest or state of motion of a body. We have discussed this some more. A force can change the direction of motion of the body, and also it can change the speed of motion of the body also, isn't it? So we have discussed it in the earlier session. Now, is there only one type of force? No, there are more different types of forces are there. You are familiar with all those forces. And one, these all type of forces which we discussed right now, that is pulling the cart, pushing the wall, these all, in all those these examples which we discussed right now in all these pictures, here all the person is doing the work. So the activity is done by the person, body parts of the person, isn't it? So his muscles are doing work. Okay, in all these examples, some muscular force, that such type of force is known as muscular force. The push, pull, etc. are done by the person, and the muscles of that person is doing force. So this type of force are known as muscular force. The activity is done by the muscles of the person, or muscles of the animals may be doing work. Therefore, such forces are called muscular forces. So muscular force is a contact force. So to get the result, the effect of force, to get the effect of force, this muscles of the body parts of the object which is applying the force, person who is applying the force, and the object should come in contact with each other. Then only its result will be occur. Okay, so here result only when the object and the person who is doing work both come in. Okay, then only the effect of force will exist. So such forces are called contact forces. So contact force is that force, the force whichever is exerting the force, the object which is exerting the force and on which the force exert, both come in contact with the each other. Then such kind of force is known as contact force. Muscular force is a contact force. Now, one thing I'll discuss here is, suppose a ball is rolling on a floor. You imagine that a ball is rolling on a floor. So, no one is exerting any force on it. But even then, the ball slowly stops. Then if no one is applied force there, then how the ball stops? Yes, there exists a force in between the ball and the floor. And this force is frictional force that you have learned in your previous class. Frictional force. There is a force exists between the ball and the floor. Okay, or floor on which the ball is rolling. So this surface and the air interact with each other with a force. There exists a force in between them, and that force is known as frictional force. Frictional force tries to oppose the motion of the body. So the frictional force is opposite to the motion of the body, and it tries to oppose the motion. And therefore, this force also is contact force. Then the body, the rolling ball and the surface, if they comes in contact with each other, then only the frictional force exists. So frictional force is a contact force. So which are the examples for contact force? Muscular force and frictional force. In the picture you can see a ball rolling on the floor and slowly comes rest. So frictional force and muscular force are example for contact force. And is there any non-contact force? Can force exist between the object even though they are not in contact with each other? Can you give some example? Yes, you can see here the picture. You can see a coconut falling from a coconut tree. So what force is exerting on the coconut which help it to fall down? Yes, it is gravitational force, isn't it? So gravitational force helps the coconut to fall down, isn't it? So the gravitational force, this gravity, the earth and the coconut is not coming in contact with each other. Even then, the earth's gravitational pull exerts on the coconut. So it drops down, isn't it? And this force is not contact force. Gravitational force is non-contact force. And here you can see a magnet. It's a force on the needle and needle pull towards the magnet. A magnet can pull objects towards it. This is a nail or a magnetic substance towards it. The magnetic force can pull the magnetic substance towards it even though magnet is not in contact with the magnetic substance like needles. Even though magnet is not in contact, it can pull the needle towards it. So the magnetic force is a non-contact force. And here you can see a child doing experiment with the scale which rubbed on hair, dry hair. The plastic scale rubbed with the dry hair. Then you can see it can attract small pieces of papers. What kind of force exerts in between? That force is known as electrostatic force. And this force also is a non-contact force. Even though the scale is not in touch with these small pieces of paper, it can attract the small pieces of paper towards its at a small distance apart. Isn't it? Even it can attract paper pieces towards it, even though the scale is not in touch with the papers. So this electrostatic force also is a non-contact force. So you have learned different types of forces now in this session, which are the contact force and non-contact force. Contact forces are that those forces which exist between two bodies which are in contact with each other. And the non-contact force is the force which exists in between two bodies which are not in contact with each other. So example for contact force are muscular force and frictional force. Non-contact force examples are gravitational force, magnetic force, electrostatic force. Hope children, all of you understood this part. And you have to just fill up these boxes. Here it is given, one table is given, 10.3, figure 10.3 you have to analyze are given, and then complete the table given in your textbook. Okay, so that is the activity for today. And here pulling a trolley, one example is given due to contact between objects. And here a coconut falling from a coconut tree, is it due to contact between objects or with no contact between objects? Yes, it is gravitational force with no contact between the force. So you have to tick the second option here with no contact between the objects. So this way you have to fill up all these points in this given in this table, and we will continue the next part in the next session. Until then, bye children.